In this video, I am going to explain muscles which do knee movement. I will explain two movements today, flexion and extension. In first part, I'm going to explain knee flexors. And on second part, I'm going to explain knee extensors. Let's jump on to hamstrings. There are three hamstrings. That is the main knee flexor. This is lateral side of knee. This is biceps femoris. Biceps femoris. Okay, this is lateral side. There are two hamstrings in medial side. This one looks thinner. You know, it looks like tendon. So this is semitendinosus. Semitendinosus. And deep to this muscle, there's thick muscle. You know, thick and very wide. Oh my gosh, this looks like membranous. So this is semimembranosus. Semimembranosus. Biceps femoris, semitendinosus, semimembranosus. These are hamstrings. Very strong knee flexors. You know. Then this is main hip flexors. From now on, I'm going to explain a little bit minor knee flexor. From this picture, you see this muscle. This is gastrocnemius. Gastrocnemius. You know, gastro is very, you know, this muscle is strong ankle muscle, right? Main function of gastrocnemius is plantar flexion of ankle. However, if you look carefully, its origin is femur. It originates from femur. What does it mean? It means this muscle crosses knee joint. This muscle crosses knee joint. Thus, it can do knee flexion. If you do knee flexion with focusing on gastrocnemius, you feel contraction on gastrocnemius. Yep, gastrocnemius does knee flexion. Three hamstrings and gastrocnemius. Let's go to deep layer. Okay, gastrocnemius is removed. I'm going to explain two muscles. This is popliteus. Popliteus, this is a popular muscle in my channel. This muscle is important for knee stability and myofascial connection. Its origin and insertion is femur and tibia. Femur and tibia. This muscle also crosses knee. Thus, it can do flexion. But, you know, if you see how big this muscle is, you know, it's not that big like hamstrings and gastrocnemius. Popliteus is not very strong knee flexor. It's weak. Its power is very weak. However, you know, every one muscle counts, right? Popliteus, knee flexor. And this one, this is very long muscle. Very long, small, thin muscle. This is also very weak knee flexor. This is plantaris. Plantaris. As name of this muscle indicates, it goes to plantar surface of foot. As you see, its tendon is very thin. Thus, plantaris is freaking weak knee flexor. It's like almost nothing. But, you know, every muscle counts. You know, that's why plantaris, I count plantaris as knee flexor in this video. Popliteus and plantaris. Let's go to medial view. There are a few more knee flexors. Okay, this is medial view. This is a medial part of tibia. This bird is Pes anserinus. Pes anserinus. There are three muscles on this place. One muscle is semitendinosus. We've already seen this muscle, right? This one is sartorius. Sartorius. It's a little bit hard to see the last one. Last one is this yellow one. This is gracilis. Gracilis. Sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus. They attach on pes anserinus. These three muscles also cross knee. Then when they contract this way, that can bring to knee flexion. Does it make sense? It's on medial part. When they contract, vector is this way, thus knee flexion. Fair enough, right? So this is pretty much it. Knee flexors. Let's go to knee extensors. This is front view. There are four muscles. Okay, they are quadriceps, four muscles, right? So this is it. You know, very simple. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button. No, I have to explain anatomy, right? There are four muscles in quadriceps. This is rectus femoris. Rectus femoris. By the way, this is only muscle in quadriceps that can do hip flexion. Okay? Hip flexion. Because this muscle originates from pelvis. Other three muscles originate from femur. Very important thing. This one is on medial part. This is vastus medialis. Vastus medialis. There's one muscle deep to rectus femoris. This is vastus intermedialis. Vastus intermedialis. You don't see this muscle in this picture. Last one. This lateral one. This is vastus lateralis. Rectus femoris, vastus medialis, vastus intermedialis, vastus lateralis. All four muscles together, it's quadriceps. Very strong knee extensor. And mass of these four muscles are humongous. It's very, very big. Thus, this muscle can exert strong power for knee extension. Knee extension is important for daily life and athletic activity. This is essential for running. You know, hamstrings is also important for running. Quadriceps is equally important. So in this video, I explained knee flexors and knee extensors. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.